Well, this 다나 스튜디오, 다나 TV. 다나 means, you know, donation. In Bali, 다나. So this 다나 스튜디오 is located near 조계사 temple. You know, you may, maybe you, someone who visited Korea, maybe you know 조계사 temple, which is headquarter of 조계 order. Downtown Seoul City. So this Dana TV studio is located near 조계사 temple. So this morning I listened to here, I mean chanting in 조계사 temple. So anyhow, now is Korean Buddhism, post lecture, post class. What's the difference between 삼국유사 and 삼국사기? Already I introduced a history book, 삼국유사 and 삼국사기. So today I'm talking about the comparison between 삼국유사 and 삼국사기. Why I'm talking about 삼국유사 and 삼국사기? Because it's very important to understand Buddhism. That's why we should know, should have knowledge about 삼국유사 and 삼국사기. That's why I'm talking about 삼국유사 and 삼국사기. So what is difference between 삼국유사 and 삼국사기? Comparison between 삼국유사 and 삼국사기. So 삼국사기 and 삼국유사 are often compared from the perspective of Korean history books. But in fact, as a matter of fact, both have important identities in Korean history. In terms of similarity, both were written by Goryeo scholars who believed that they were descendants of the Silla, not Goguryeo. Therefore, this contributed to the emphasis on highlighting the history of Silla in both 삼국유사 and 삼국사기. You understand what I'm talking about? Because 삼국유사 and 삼국사기 were compiled by scholars, Goryeo dynasty, but they are from Silla. That's why put some kind of more important than Goguryeo and Baekje. So in contrast, however, there are some differences. First, if the author of 삼국유사 was a Buddhist monk, 삼국사기 was written by 김부식, a Confucian scholar and politician. So readers can encounter two different historical works from the viewpoint of Buddhism and Confucius. So what it means that 삼국유사 is written by monk and 삼국사기 is written by Confucianist. The Cultural Heritage Administration said this book, 삼국유사, contains a wide range of records about the young soldiers of the Silla dynasty, which are more religious and poetic than the 삼국사기. On the other hand, according to study, the Chronicles of the Three Kingdoms was accepted almost immediately as one of the most definitive historical books of the time and was read in China after several decades. The monk Iryon, 100 years later, relies heavily on 삼국사기, and 삼국유사 contains historical elements that are not in 삼국사기. This is a very important point. You should concentrate on this point. So while 김부식 tried to a more rational and logical approach to the historical writing, the romantic and Buddhist approach to Korea, 삼국유사, allow the leaders to experience all the historical culture, such as shamanism, folklore, and mythology. Both histories focus on a specific background, usually in terms of religion. Despite the sensible writing of the chronicles of the Three Kingdoms, nationalist historians and scholars call it a book centered on Chinese Confucianism, arguing that it instills sade that ignore ancient tradition. Sade means sub-big. Sade means sade, sub-big, sade. But at the time, China is big. Korea is, Korean Peninsula is small. So maybe Korea serves the China, some kind of. So on the other hand, in the case of Sangguk Yusa, most of the text is dedicated to Buddhism. Of course, the content of the Sangguk Yusa cannot help but be influenced by the Buddhist value of Iryon and the Sangguk-sagi. Iryon's work present four bizarre stories depicting the discovery of archaeological artifact to prove the existence of Buddhism in the pre-modern era, the age of folk tales. In Sangguk-yosa, the period of the Three Kingdoms is the period when various systems, teachings, religious ceremonies, and ancestral rites began. Folk tales are both descriptive and normative because they have become the source of Korean Buddhism tradition to this day. As the birth of tradition is described in books, the place mentioned in this book are important religious point in Korea today. The name of the mountain in Sangguk Yusa connect Korea, China, and India, and symbolically recreate the actual Buddhist holy site in Korea. Most of the tales in Sangguk Yusa include a common purpose in which the remains of temples and Buddhist statues are discovered and disclosed in key places such as mountains. This includes Silla's holy ground, which can be said to be a religious strategic point of Silla. In addition, Monk Iryon introduced Korea as a country with the best karma in the universe to build a giant Buddha statue that it is more suitable than India, the home of Buddhism. The story of Sangguk Yusa recruit 10,000 Buddhas, Bodhisattvas who changed themselves as different mountain tops. The story also introduced Korea as a country which the best karma in the world for producing larger Buddha statues than India, the birthplace of Buddhism. The mountain was later changed into one large religious area containing several temples and shrines. Each location was dedicated to a specific Buddha or Bodhisattva and was used for the rituals to be performed. Maybe someone visit Korea, when you go to mountain temples, learned about the name of mountains connecting to Buddhism, Most of mountains in Korea connecting to Buddhist terms. That's what talking about. The religion in Korea Religion in Korea is diverse nowadays. Many Koreans are not religious. Christianity, Protestantism, and Catholicism, and Buddhism are the dominant confession among those who have subscribed to the former religions. Buddhism and Confucianism play an influential role in the lives of many Koreans. Buddhism, which entered Korea in AD 372, built tens of thousands of temples throughout the country. According to Pew Research Center in United States, about 46% of the population is non-religious, 20% Buddhist, and 29% Christian. According to the 2015 National Census, non-religious people are 56.1%, Protestant 19.7%, Korean Buddhist 15.5%, and the Catholics 7.9%, and minority of Koreans 0.8% of the total adhere to other religions, including One Buddhism, Confucianism, 천도교, 대순진리의 이슬람, 대종교, 중상교, and Eastern Orthodoxy. According to a Gallup Korean poll in 2021, 60% were non-religious, 17% Protestant, 16% Buddhist, 6% Catholic, and 1% other. So this is religions in Korea, the situation. So as you know, Buddhism was long history. Buddhism has long history in Korea, anyhow. Like in Korea Dynasty, Buddhism was a state religion. And Joseon Dynasty, Buddhism was another state religion. Confucianism was a state religion. So nowadays, situation is somehow, as Pew Research mentioned that 60% were non-religious people. So 17% Protestant, 16% Buddhist, 6% Catholic. It means Christianity more than 23%. This is a religious situation in Korea, modern in Korean society. So now I introduced what is Sangguk-yosa and Sangguk-sagi, and also I introduced the situation of Korean, Korean religions. Well, as I mentioned previous lectures, in order to understand Korean Buddhism, so in this class, not only I introduce Buddhism, but also other religion also, I will, introduce from time to time. So what is the point? Today's lecture's point is Samgung-yosa and Sangguk-sagi, books, history books. If you want to understand what Korean Buddhism is like, then you should know Sangguk-sagi, Samgung-yosa. According to Samgung-yosa and Sangguk-sagi, you understand the ancient Korean history and how Buddhism came from China to Korea. So, thank you very much thank you very much listening my lecture. Thank you. See you again. 감사합니다.